वो
एंड
तो डिस्कशन
नाउ
कल हो गया, वो तो मैडम से भी डिस्कशन हो गया था, सो वी विल बी डूइंग दैट, दैट्स ओके, वी ऑलरेडी
द
डिस्कस,
क्लासरूम सेशंस
या
कंफर्टेबल
वी डू दैट, ये वर्चुअल तो क्या नहीं,
वंडरफुल
वही मैं बताऊं, आप
वंडरफुल
रिकॉर्ड शुरू करो, वर्षा शुरू करो.
यस यस शिखा शैल बी स्टार्ट वर्षा वी कैन वर्षा ओके ओके गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल सो वर्षा या गुड मॉर्निंग या टेल मी गो अहेड ओके ओके सो गुड
वर्षा
मॉर्निंग
गो
ऑल
अहेड गो अहेड.
मिस्टर डी के बख्शी विद अस ही इज अ चीफ मेंटर एंड सीईओ ऑफ ग्लोबल टैलेंट कंपनी ही इज अ ग्लोबल लीडरशिप कोच नोन एज अ मिस्टर मोटिवेटर एंड मिस्टर एनर्जी आई विल रिक्वेस्ट टू मिस्टर बख्शी टू स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम ओवर टू यू सर
Thanks, Varsha, and I can see Shikha, ma'am, there from the learning and development team of JCB. I have with me Mr. Manoj Agarwal, who is our star trainer on the technical trainings. And of course, those who have not been able to attend, I would certainly like them to watch this once they get the recording. Good morning, JCB family. My name is DK Bakshi. I am from the company called Global Talent Company. In India, we are known as Global Talent Company India Private Limited, which is an ISO 9001 2015 version company. Global talent is spread in global world, starting from headquarters, Bangkok, Malaysia, Singapore, of course, India and North America. And we are an organization wherein we are on various verticals of talent acquisition excellence, talent development excellence, HROD excellence, and manufacturing excellence and business excellence. In fact, today, when I am talking to you, I am extremely happy and thankful to the management of JCB to give us an opportunity to be partnering with them on the people development. The power of people. The power of people is our capability, both on the technical side as well as on the software skill side. When you look at Global Talent Company, we have over last 10 years trained more than 250,000 people around the world in near about 16 countries, almost 16, 17 nationalities. Our signature programs, when we talk about leadership as well as the soft skills, are roadmap to sustainable success, DNA of leadership, one dream, one team, romancing with destiny. These are my signature programs, well known globally. And the other side, when I have at the huge list of training, starting from, I am myself trained by Dr. Thakurji, living Guru of Quality Management, TQM. I am the facilitator on behalf of Taguchi methodology in the countries over as India is concerned. So TQM, TPM, Six Sigma, 5S, you name it, from quality circles, Kaizens, employee engagement models, and the shop floor small group activities. I have with me this morning one of our great star technical trainers known as Manoj Agarwal. Manoj is over two decades of experience, and last 10 years he has worked with us in companies in Maruti Suzuki. In Maruti Suzuki itself, we have trained more than 2,000 people, and he has worked with us at United Breweries Diageo company. He has been in FMCG, consumer durable manufacturing, automotive, as well as service industry. He is a very varied experience in terms of technical trainings. And when we are talking about APQP and other models, he is one of a very competent trainer known in the country today. So today's session, which is an introductory session, will be taken up by Manoj Agarwal ji. And going forward, frankly speaking, I was discussing yesterday also with the head of HR. Going forward, we have had a very bad year of 2020, where I have personally done 300 webinars around the world. But this has been all on digital mode. We are not the people of digital mode. Of course, digital is going to be part of our lives. There's no doubt about it. But saying that digital will make an impact, especially when we are talking about people development, probably not. Because there's a lot of issues, challenges. So it is always better to do face-to-face trainings wherein the understanding into the DNA becomes much more impactful. Myself and even Manoj Agarwal, who, as I said, has been the lead facilitator for us for the technical trainings, we always believe, unless and until we are with the people into the classroom and address issues and challenges, what they face, and then apply that in their day-to-day activities. Because our programs are not just for the sake of having a workshop or a program. Our programs are, after the programs are done, it is applied and we review whether the application has been done in the same manner what has been taught. And there are opportunities for us that going forward, when we will be doing the programs, we will be reviewing, creating review mechanism so that the understanding, so that there's a value for money. And I respect JCB as an organization who spend a lot of, whose focus is people, people, and people. And having said that, when we are talking about this 2020, it has been one of the most toughest, most difficult VUCAs of our world. We had never thought in February 2020 or in March 2020 that we will be in the same fashion till end of December, that is today, 31st of December 2020. Hey God, please allow us to walk in into 2021 with much more vigor, and let air opens up, let this social distances go away, and let's human race should be together. Because unless human race is together, we cannot create that kind of situation in life. I have been propagating during this period, power of positivity leading to power of persistence, leading to power of perseverance, leading to power of passion, leading to power of performance, and leading to power of progress, and finally leading to power of pride. So all these powers combined together have taken us out from this COVID. And I created a couple of models, and one of the models is very hit on the social media, which is known as COVID ability. COVID ability, that's a new competency of our world. So ladies and gentlemen, whosoever is going to be watching this introductory session, this COVID ability is agility, business ability, capability, deliverability, engageability, flexibility, and guideability, and high potential ability and innovation ability. I repeat, agility, business ability, capability, deliverability, engageability, flexibility, guideability, that is mentoring, coaching, HIPO, H-I-P-O, high potential ability and innovation ability. Because what has happened in the world, which I am trying to talk here, the capabilities and the competencies required in February 2020, probably no more valid today in December 31st, December 2020. And probably by April 2021, no more. So in order to be competent, in order to be in the human race professionals, whether you are in HR, you are in manufacturing, you are in supply chain, or you are in marketing, sales, stores, warehouse, production, or engineering, all of us have really gone through a lot of change. So objective of our training programs at JCB would be, how do we move our people to the next level of excellence, to the next level of excellence, to the next level of excellence, so that they become better professionals along with better human beings in order to create value for themselves, value for organization, value for the country, and value for the global world. We are Indians, one world, one love, and one family, and one human race, irrespective of caste, creed, gender, nationality, religion, and color. So that is the background of our global talent company. That is the approach we have. And I would like to wish each and every employee of JCB a great Happy New Year 2021. full of wonderful opportunities. And may God help the human race to walk in tonight into a new world of 2021, which all of us are aspiring. Many people have gone through pain. We have lost some of our good people in our lives. We have had a lot of issues, but let's move forward. Let's move forward. That is the message I would like to give. And I would request now my star trainer on behalf of Global Talent Company to take us through this APQP introductory model, and he can touch other models as well, so that the JCB family gets an idea about what kind of training we are doing. Wish you all the best. I wish every employee of JCB all the best and good luck for 2021. May we prosper, may air opens up, may life open up, and we are together on a mission of creating a great, proud company of JCB, and we partner with JCB in people development. Thank you very much. Over to Manoj Agarwal.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Very good morning, Ms. Shikha from JCB.
Good morning, sir.
So-called Mr. Motivator, Mr. Energy, and very inspired one, right? And this year could not be better than this. At the end of the day of the 2020, we are partnering with a kind of a company, is a JCB, is a global talent company, right? And so I think my motivation level has gone up by listening for last 5-10 minutes. And of course, Ms. Varsha, who has coordinated this session. So although we all know that this APQP is a going from 2 days to 3 day sessions, if you go in a very detail, but it's an introductory. I have tried to keep it short, critical points to touch upon, which can have a business impact. What is the need for this APQP in relevance of even today's business scenario, even in after in the new normal situations. So APQP is not a, you can say, very new concepts. Even if in India, if we talk about, it is in practice since 1997, when the QS 9000, one of the quality management system standard, was being forced into practice for the three bigs, General Motor, Chrysler and Ford. And I was lucky enough to be part of that journey of QS 9000 when I was working with one of the automotive organizations in parabolic and suspensions, leaf springs basically. So we were seventh basically in India when we deployed all core tools of this automotive standards, right through APQP, PPAP, FMEA, SPC and MSA. So today I'm planning to share with you why it is needed, how it is more relevant in today's perspective. Like we have also facilitated various automotive OEMs, be it you call it a Volvo Eicher, you call it a Tata Motors, or we call it a TAFE also. We have facilitated the teams of these OEMs to implement this APQP process more effectively, because the pain basically we see in industry as a part of the new product development process. Once the sample is developed and the pilot lot is produced and approved, but the problem start coming when we go into productionization. So conceptualization to production, product realization actually on the shop floor, we face a lot of challenges. So how we can move on and how we can more robust designing of this particular process, this I'm going to share with you. I'm starting my screen sharing with you. Just please confirm me if is visible to everyone.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Thank you. Maybe I will go through all the slides, so may not be, but I'm trying to cover up what is the intent of being here for the next 45 minutes or 40 minutes or 1 hour. So advanced product quality planning, although this is very much you can say popular practices in automotive, but if you see any business sectors, be it a telecom, be it a insurance, be it other manufacturing, everywhere this concept of APQP or PPAP or this new product development is applicable, very much applicable. So I'm just skipping few slides. I'm just straight away, this is already shared. So if we see that today, what I'm trying to focus on is the course objective. When we go in the classroom, basically, what will be the course objective? Basically, we will take it where, what is the purpose of doing the new product development? What is the challenge today? Even if we see today, speed and quality, these two are the fundamental, basically, where we see 0 second delay and zero defect. We go for a lot of actions once the problem is occurred in our production. Then we go back to our process, what we have set the process as a part of process designing. So if we can take care at the time of the new product development process itself, where there is a focus area we should have while we go for this training also, we will definitely focus what is your first time right in the new product development process. What is the percentage on-time delivery that we can have? Because customer does not wait, basically. For customer, a speedy launch of your product, which gives you an edge in the market in this competitive world, is very much important. Being in a new product development process, we have to focus on four indicators, as mentioned here also. First time right in a new product development, on-time development, and budget is very important, cost. I have seen in the various company while facilitating and training on this APQP process, X cost has been budgeted while submitting the quotation to the customer. But we see in the actual in the shop floor while in production, our profit is start getting dilating, is getting downsizing. What is the reason behind it? Maybe we have done some X practice while developing the product, or maybe we are making a more number of sample than required by the customer, and we are celebrating the success that our sample is approved by the customer in a first go. But actually it is not so. We have made a more sample, we have inspected 100%, we have segregated as a good sample and submitted to customer. So when we go internal into production, lot of problems industry face. So the purpose is here, right through stage one to stage five. That are the five phases of the APQP, basically, that I'm trying to cover up in a brief in today sessions. Another objective is no new product development process is completed unless we have an integration of the core tools, so-called like your FMEA, your MSA, your SPC. Because one of the aspects basically in the business, either you call it is a business risk or you call it is a process risk. So FME is a kind of the tool where we talk about the risk analysis. So there is an interlinkage in between your FMEA, MSA and SPC to achieve the goal, be it your quality goal, be it your reliability goal or durability goal or function and performance goals of your products. So all these are very neat to take, to be taken care while going for this new product development process. Our methodology, basically, while we go into the classrooms, our methodology will be with the classroom lectures, group exercise on a case studies. Even we can customize our case studies based on the client processes. So normally we ask the clients to give in some inputs on their processes so we can customize that. We can have a group presentations among the teams who are participating in the sessions. We can have some kind of video clippings of practical exercises. We can we will always go with the pre and post test evaluations, verbal feedback and written feedback and commitment on implementation. Because unless you are committed to implement your learnings what you had in a 2 day session, 3 day session or 1 day sessions, then only it adds the value to your business objectives. And then, of course, when we have a pre and a post test evaluations, then definitely we will have a post test marks, case study presentations, and finally the program feedback. So if any input from your side, Shikha, definitely it will be appreciable in our methodologies and approach that we are presenting here. It can be incorporated accordingly. So that will be our methodology. Target participants normally we look for during this program. Normally industry nominates or designates the participants from their engineering functions, maybe product or process engineering, quality, supplier quality, then manufacturing, procurement, maintenance and tool engineering sometimes are left out. But they play a very, very vital role in achieving our objective of the new product development process first time right. While you do the FMEA as a part of your NPD process in the third phase of the APQB process design and development, or if you go in a product design and development, if you want to de-risk your process in terms of achieving the zero defect, definitely the team across all the functions which have a value addition onto your product in the process, it must be a part of this learning process. So that's our understanding about the target participants. Even if you want to add other functions also like logistics or supply chain, right, stores, that is also acceptable, or they can also join. Now I'm just presenting you, this is a 3-day module. It can be depend on. If we are going for 2 days, we can customize it for 2 days. If you see, this is very well in detail. If you start with the APQP workshop, from day one, I have break up into even timings and resource requirements even. Because while doing an exercise, we will be requiring like sometimes A4 papers, then component drawing, assembly drawing, child part drawing, templates for feasibility study and risk analysis, what currently JCB is following. If not, yes, we can also come up with the kind of templates. Like we have facilitated, I have personally facilitated, like Swedish company Husqvarna for their own plants in China and their suppliers. So we have that mechanism. If you want me to introduce you JCB with the VDA 6.3 kind of concepts for this program management or project management basically, so we can follow the same. So we must know in advance before going into the classroom training, what is the templates or what is the systems basically, or are you following exactly the IITF guidelines or any specific templates that you want? So we can have a mix of that and which suits to you. I will share you one template today of a new product development Excel. I will show you after this session. So if you see in the 5 phases of APQP, I have divided each and every session and broken up into when we can have an exercise, when we can have a lunch breaks, or even if we go for a PFD or PFMEA, what are the resources we can have? FMEA rating tables, which is very important. Even AIAG VDA FMEA 5th edition is in place. Most of the industries are asking today to conduct a session on FMEA 5th edition. My submission to all these industries, have we implemented even FMEA 3rd edition in a full sprint? Because FMEA risk analysis tool, FMEA 5th edition is quite little bit completely changed from the earlier edition. But intent is not changed. So first we should be very clear about it, what we want to achieve. So let's say whatever is available with you during the sessions, we will exchange before the session starts and we will customize accordingly. So you can see in this 3 consecutive slides, I am taking you to the different topics covering into the 5 phases. Even if you see basic stats, process characterization, because APQB is the name is the 5 phases. But there is a mix of the various tools and techniques that we need to implement to achieve the speed and the quality that we want basically. So data collection sheet, your control plan templates, your stats estimation sheets, wherever you are calculating your standard deviation, variations, average, like that. Even I have added one more thing here. If you see, in addition to what APQP in actual does not specify in a APQP reference manual, that is kind of concept of the Six Sigma. Like we still today monitor in terms of PPMs. But I am putting here, if we want to achieve the zero defect, so I should not work on the defective parts per million. I should work on the DPU, defects per million opportunity. I should work on the roll throughput yield. If my process is going through the various number of the processes, various phases, what is my roll throughput yield actually? So we are introducing the concept of Six Sigma also as a basic concepts to understand the process efficiencies and effectiveness. People are very, sometimes it is very difficult to differentiate between efficiency and effectiveness when we ask the people on the actually on the shop floor. So the production people are very much required in this training. And the last day, when we move on, so again, SPC overview in terms of APQP process design and development and the fourth phase, product process verifications and the validations. So we need to go for a process capability studies, initial process capability studies, measurement system analysis studies, because MSA plan, SPC plan, all will part of the third phase of the process design and development. But during the sample development, when we go for a pilot lot, basically. So in pilot lot, actually, we have to execute, demonstrate the capability in terms of our measurement systems. And here, what I see the opportunity missed basically in industry while doing a new product development is a right selection of your measuring instrument. In most of the industry, if we see conflict with the new product development team and the production team or the quality team on the shop floor, we are not achieving the process capability. We are getting the more defects. Then I normally ask the people, what is the CTQ of the particular product? What is the process capability the customer is demanding? If they say 1.67, and normally I have seen in industry a thumb rule of selecting the measuring instrument as a 1/10 of the tolerance. If you are selecting the 1/10 of the tolerance, and then you are expecting my measurement system will read the variation of a 1.67 kind of capability, my measurement system will be incapable. So right selection of the measuring instruments is very, very important. That should be very well taken care in the process design and development into the third phase. So that's where we will move on to all five phases in the 3 days. It can be customized in 2 days if it is required. I have just detailed it out. And this is a kind of workshop resource requirement. I have just put it up, maybe a little bit more or less out of it, if you see. I have written in the minimum 2 APQP or PPM file must be available for review. If we have, even if it is 1, it is good, because this will help us to do an exercise with the participants in the various groups. So that way we can. So I just divided 3-day session into various like that. 2.5-day classroom come shop floor workshop like this. Half day phases and stages, alignment interactions, review of improvement aligning with concept of following 8D approach. If we are not successful, we are not effective enough in the sample development, like a Maruti concept, they go for a T1, T2, T3 samples. Some other OEMs go with a different approach of sample development and piloting. So we can follow the same approach here for solving the problems. As already Bakshi has told, VUCA environment. So I'm not going to repeat that. But this is very much relevant today to ensure that whatever you establish during the product development stage, it must sustain during the running production. That is a major gap nowadays in industry. So at the end, if you see in the kind of business environment, I see the motivated team that should be doing it. Then the good profit at the end, we always, if we add the value, definitely we will be business competitive. We will not only the cost competitive. So that our objective is to make your process, make your organization by adopting such kind of the methodologies, new product development, we should, your organization should be business competitive. We should not say we are a least cost supplier. We should say we are a business competitive in all the aspects, be it your energy cost, be it your logistic cost, while you calculate or do the costing estimation and submitting to the customer, basically. So we should see as a whole perspective. We should not see APQP as a part of your QMS process. you should see APQP as a part of your business management system, business management process, we should call it. So we will focus on how we can have a sustained profitability, what you designed at the time of the new product development, basically, and definitely on time. On time delivery is very, very important. Wherever we talk with the industry for improvement projects, 50 to 60% industries are struggling with the on-time delivery. They say, we deliver the product what we have committed in the month, but not on time. So on time, if we don't, whatever lead time, whatever capacity analysis, whatever you have done the cycle time study during this product and process designing base, process designing, like we say in the IATF, evaluated flow space utilization, we say synchronous flow of the material, using the kind of the lean concepts, we should not treat APQP or PPAP like 18 documents or 17 documents. We should see the actual implementations and realize the effectiveness of this particular process. Fourth, that I'm talking about zero defect. Personally, I have witnessed in most of the industry during some kind, sometimes assessment also, there is cost of poor quality. And now if you see, in wherever this IATF 16949 2016 or earlier TS 16949 was in place, at least in automotive, at least in Delhi NCR region, I have not seen any industry whose COPQ is more than 2%. They show to the auditor, IATF auditor, 1%, 0.8%, 1.5%. But at the same time, when we ask, what is your OEE? What is your efficiencies? They say it is 70%, 74%. Then I say it cannot be less than 15% in your organization. And when you go digging it out, actually what is happening in India, we are going for correction, like a seven waste, Timbuktu. Why we are not taking care this Timbuktu concept while doing the new product development? So when we do this workshop at your end, we will definitely try to understand what are the non-valued activities are taking place in your organizations and how we can integrate, right, your process in such a way there is no opportunity, right, where we will see is there any NVAs in your process. Because value is the driver of your profitability. If you don't add the value, then definitely your profitability is going down. And of course, in the last is a happy customer. And happy customer is not only external, it is internal. So that's the theme that we are talking, and we are taking this NPD journey with the five principles of the lean, where we say first identify the value. In the NPD, in a one particular product, what customer values, what is the perceived value of the customer, what exactly he want as a customer requirement and expectation gathering. This is the first step when you go into new product development process. So from there we will move on and we will see, while you do the process mapping, we will show for create a flow. While you're designing a process, you design a process based on the pull concept, not on the push concepts. I'm designing my process not only to produce the right product. I'm not designing my process to for the on-time delivery. I'm also designing my process to have a zero inventory, actually. But of course, there is a certain inefficiency in our system because my customer is not paying for holding the material in between the processes. My customer is not paying for inspection. Why we design the inspection process while doing the new product development? So we have to build a culture basically right through the first stage. I think Shikha, she's joining in back, right. So, and finally, that is the pursue perfection, mistake-proofing concepts and other concepts that we see. So I'm just giving you a view of value is the driver of the profitability. And since cost is not, price is not in your control, it is decided by the either competition or the customer. So we are only left out with the cost. So we have to design the cost in such a way that we should not feel regret while we go into actual production. I personally remember the Volvo Eicher in the case of 2012 and 13, they outsourced me PPAP, on-site PPAP, witness in the PPAP at a client site. Problem was this, purchaser was asking PPAP from the supplier. Supplier was giving the 18 documents as a file. Purchaser was approving it. right, was in a hurry to get approved from quality, and then immediate very next lot was rejected on the production line. And you can understand, if the truck comes out every 5.5 minutes, right, from the Volvo Eicher line, then 10 minutes stoppage in the line. If it debited to supplier, then supplier cannot survive. So the better path is to design your process right through this. So definitely we will talk about, while designing the new product development process, value-added activities and non-value-added activities. And develop a habit to do the first time right. I remember normally I also talk about the quality group will be Crosby quote, concept of draft. Do right always first time. We have to design the process for the first time right. We put a fire extinguisher in the plant, not for this, the fire will take place. We take as a preventive measures basically. So similar way, we should plan our process, keeping in mind what is the end basically, not where we are today. If we are today, then we start stepping on, we can move only 3-4 steps. But if we target the end, what the customer demands, what is our targets, maybe we can left out with the 1 or 2 steps back. So that's the concepts. And if what are the NVS in your process, categorize in the concept of teamwork, we should to identify during this stage only. We should not leave it out. Normally it is a habit of the industries basically. So that's we will focus. So purpose is here. Make a model basically. You can see your process is a world class level where 3.4 defects per million opportunity in your process that you design. And when you see there is only 3 capabilities. One is your process capabilities. Another is your product design capabilities. Another is your supplier capabilities. Even if you design the entire process very beautifully and excellent, but your supplier is not supporting enough, right? Then of course your process will not achieve the objective and the goals what you have decided. So in a process design and development phase, when we design our internal process in terms of your toolings, in terms of your machinery, in terms of your measurement system, and if suppose it is an assembly and your suppliers supply you the various child parts for assembly, components, definitely we should take this process at the supplier end. That's why I have written in the participant, maybe if someone is there for the supplier quality, right? He should be also part of this journey. So 3 process we need to make it very much capable if we want to ensure that 3.4 defects per million. So that's it. These are the 5 phases of the APQB, if you see, starting from phase 1 of planning, plan and define the program, where we do kind of understanding customer requirement and expectations. And very much the first step is team feasibility and the risk analysis. Team feasibility commitment and the risk analysis. Normally what missed opportunity we have seen in the industries while doing this feasibility and the risk analysis, why at the time of, suppose if you require a development of some mold and die and the tools, that time we need to see commercial risk. What is the commercial risk involved into it? Is it a one-time volume or it is a repetitive volume from your customer? Amortization process. So that's where we need to see. Another is what the standard is sometimes demand, like aligning with your zero defect, zero effect concepts. Is the product is having any impact on the environment? So that is the environmental risk that we need to understand. And then you submit your quotations, preparing a bill of material, identification of list of characteristics, completely this, and then you get an LOI or you can say order from the customer to develop in a sample. So that's way it goes into the various phases from product design and development. If JCB is a design responsible organization, definitely your product design and development will be applicable. Else process design and development, all the steps, the end where we see of the third phase is developing the sample prototype, submitting to the customer, getting approval from the customer, and moving to the pilot phase in the fourth phase, product and process validation, where the objective of this product and process validation is set the process in such a way that the same will be followed during the production. So it will help you. Product and process validation will help you to set your right process of process audit in the running production. And finally, once your pilot is approved, like a JCB kind of industry or as for construction kind of the products that normally we talk about. You are referring your PPAP manual, your pilot size, it can be different. So that we need to decide with the customer, how much size you take and like that. And final phase is production, where we talk about feedback assessment corrective actions of your phase four and APQP planning sign off basically at the last phase to make it regularized productions and listing it out, things gone right, things gone wrong, that can be taken as a learning from the previous journey of this APQP of the different products. So that's where we capture it. So in the five phases. This is a different method I have just put up of another OEMs where we faceted in China. Earlier one, it was directly guidelines from the AIG guidelines of APQP, but few customers followed it like this. So I'm just presenting it like that. If you see here, they have defined like a specification stage to development stage to industrialization stage to production stage to sales stage. So there is a different gates basically they've defined here. This already, like I told you, like voice of customer to customer requirement and voice of process, your actual process. So voice of customer, we need VOC, we must capture very correctly and efficiently. Output of each phase becomes an input for the another phase. So not elaborating much, but there is an interlinkage between all these five phases of the APQP. Very important few slides I'm talking about when you go with this APQP process, starting with the program planning. And very, very important here. We normally observe in their timing plan, project management chart, project Gantt chart, customer need date is missing. So we should first capture customer need date, then work backwards for all the phases, and then accordingly establish the objective. This is another one, like quality, reliability, durability, functionability. So what are the goals basically? So that's we should start in the program planning part. MDT, very, very important. We found missing this MDT concept in various industry. So multidisciplinary teams is very important, ensuring the review as a team feasibility and the risk analysis. I already like told you environmental effect or commercial risk. So what the risk analysis we do as the RFQ we receive from the customer. So it's a very, very starting point in the new product development process. Degree of manufacturing complexity. Again, this is a one. What is your capability? One is a capacity, another is a capability. Maybe you have a capacity, a spare capacity, to meet the volumes requirement of the customer. Maybe you are having a capability, customer is demanding to produce in a 50 micron, but you have a capability of only 80 microns. So how you resolve this conflict as per the standard requirement? We should not decide the target so stretchable or in line with the customer, except the customer requirement, that we always give them corrective action only. So we should discuss with the customer, resolve the issues before actually going into the sample production or the pilot production. So pre-delivery or post-delivery, there should be a very much difference. While I talk about the FMEA, the risk analysis, basically, I always see the PFMEA is a wonderful tool, excellent tool if industry realize. But unfortunately, I am for last 23 years, I've seen very, very few industries has really applied this practice of FMEA. I personally applied in 1997 when I was a part of Jamna Auto Industries in Jay Springs, right, supplying to US Shreveport and Detroit plant. We did religiously all FMEAs for all the manufacturing processes. It was done only on Sunday, sir, not on the working days. So our entire management, including the top management, we ensured that there should not be any defects, zero defects in that. So FMEA approach for de-risking process is very much in real spirit is required. So I will definitely focus in your workshop for FMEA, maybe going for 1 hour, 2 hours during that workshop, but detailed definitely FMEA sessions will be different in that way. I have shown here picture of the onion, because why I am keeping here, because onion has a multiple layers. Unless we unlayer all the layers till we reach to the root, and every onion has a root. We have a habit of, when we caught up with a fever, we immediately take an naproxen or a crocin. It gives a relief for a certain moment or few hours, but again, we have to go to the basics. So that is very important. So FMEA is a risk analysis tool. Special characteristic. Critical, like we call it, CT. It depends on, like, sometimes customers say critical, major, minor, sometimes say, so it depends on customer what he designates basically. As per IATF guidelines, if you say it is called a special characteristic, very, very important, while you go for a special characteristics designing and the normal characteristic designing, and your step is like your process flow diagram, then your FMEA, then your control plans. Very important to understand in the IPQP process, in the new product development process, is designing your right sample size in control plans. What sample size you will have? Normally, even if you have a control plants at your plant, you see there is one is a size, another is a frequency. In how many hours you will check these two pieces? Two pieces every hour or one piece every hour. It's very, very important to decide your sample size and frequency. So special characteristic and their plan. And very important, then the finally is the program management. If you take care of your very well doing a risk analysis, very well taking care of your special characteristic, in-depth understanding of your customer requirement and expectation, and aligning your project Gantt charts, then definitely your time versus effort, if you see, if you put a good time to launch your products in a systematic manner to achieve your speed and quality, definitely your effort will be less, time may be more, but it will be very systematic. And this is a cycle like APQP to FMEA control plan and work instruction. People, what they do, normally after process flow, they go for a control plan. That is easy shortcuts. But actually the control plans will be derived from the process FMEA. And this is a sample that I have put up for a full run test report when you go for a pilot run. So this we have facilitated the clients, where we can, at the initial stage itself, if you are able to see this particular, you can see in the different column there is a process names. If you see in the left hand side, there is a working time calculations, the target, the full run test results, and finally full run test results. If you see inputs and results. So at the time of new product development, we have established what is our designed OE, what is our designed scrap, what is our first time right. If we are deviating from this in our running production, definitely we need to go back and look into the process, what we have designed actually during this process design and development, as well as in the process and product validations. So this is a sheet basically when you run a pilot in your plant, in your organizations, check the performance of your product, keep it as a master, and when you do the process audit or revalidate your process, again see, is there any change? So that is a comparison that we can always have. So that's from my side as a short, basically what we decided today in an introductory sessions. Maybe I have left out with certain things in it. So you can ask me any questions if you want to ask me. So it will be welcome. Thank you, Shikha.
Hi. Good Hi. Morning. So it was wonderful listening to you, and it was wonderful. Sorry, DK, so you're saying something?
Yeah, you say, then I can close. But I wanted to say, first of all, Manoj San, thank you very much. You took us through the journey very beautifully. And yeah. I must admit, with your background and experience, which you have done in various organizations in India and abroad, it has laid a very good impact of what is going to be coming in the offering. I have only a couple of things which I would like to add on you before we request to come. It is a very important Shikha, ma'am. And the operation head and the manufacturing head who would be going through this recording. Before even getting into this, we need to know the applications. We use that JCB. That is where, you know, because the customized, the tailor-made, customized model can be designed by Manoj-san once he knows what are the applications being used. Because he will go for a completely tailor-made, you know, my shirt is completely tailor-made. So we design and develop a tailor-made model for the organizations so that it adds to the value what he was talking about. It's going to be a way of life. Finally, zero defect is going to be a way of life at JCB. In terms of putting that piece concept we talk about, people, processes, products, productivity, progress, profitability, and finally pride. Because anything and everything, whatever he is going to be doing, has got to add value to the bottom line. Second, has got to add value to people thinking, has got to add value to the productivity norms, SOPs, which already must be there as a multinational organization. We don't say that you will not have. But in order to improve those SOPs in line with the thing APQP, he will take them to the next and the next level of excellence. So therefore, my request, I always request HR people and the manufacturing and operations head, please declare training program as a business process. Like supply chain is a business process, manufacturing is a business process, warehousing is a business process. So every, whatever we are working, you know, working from, you know, IQC to the warehouse and to the loading, unloading, loading and going to the customer is a business process. So similarly, when we are talking about training, it should be declared, it should be rather in the business plan that training and development, whether it is leadership, whether it is team building, whether it is resolving conflicts, whether it is TPM, TQM, APQP, or any kind of training, it should be a business process. And the moment we create these training as business process, people will have a mindset that this is my business. This is not training program. Because otherwise, what happens when we say there is a training program? You see, I have been head of the director HR with 17, 18 countries, and I have seen this happening every day, and I used to talk about this. You know, in Europe, we used to charge employees to attend training program, and 10% of their cost was being debited to their salary. And when you debit 10% of the cost of the training to the employee, they would attend full time because 10% is gone. But in Asia or in America or in Middle East, we don't have this kind of, it's all free for the employee. And when it is free for an employee, he takes it lightly. And then when manufacturing head or a manufacturing man, are training program hai, kaun sa, are yaar, agli baar jayega yaar, aaj kaam hai. Sorry to say, my folded hands to manufacturing managers, operation managers, and department heads and functional heads. This is normally what we do on day-to-day basis. While as you need to give so much of importance to training. Training program, my God, you must attend and let me know what you have learned. And I want you to apply those things on the shop floor, on your day-to-day work. So therefore, the moment you declare this as business process, the seriousness of individuals who are attending the program, as well as their supervisors, whether supervisor is a manufacturing manager or a general manager, vice president, becoming much more important. Having said that, finally, our objective, our mission is to add value to people, processes, products, productivity, leading to profitability, progress with passion and pride. Therefore, having said that, whatever journey he has shared, and when he practically goes on day-to-day basis into the classroom, there will be a lot of questions, there'll be a lot of deliberations, there'll be a lot of discussions, and then scaling down and enhancing SOPs will be one of an important factor for your manufacturing and operational heads. That is what I would say. And at the end, I would say, Manoj-san, absolutely very clear. First time, first right is the philosophy, and customer delight, customer excitement, in-house as well as outside. Jab in-house hi nahi hai, bahar ja hi nahi sakti hai. So internal customization leading to external customization. I don't know, Shikaji, whether you have departmental agreements of in-house customization or not. I have done it practically in 17, 18 countries where HR has an agreement with manufacturing, manufacturing has an agreement with quality, quality has an agreement with supply chain. Every department has a contract. Like I have, yesterday I signed a contract with you as a partner to you, as a service provider to you. So that contract is signed within the company between various departments. There are expectations and there are deliverables, there are timelines. So again, aap internal customer concept built up karoge, I can promise it to you that you will have the customer delight and customer excitement from the final customer. Today we have an opportunity in this country, and I always talk about this, that make in India. So we are, you are a multinational company as an English company, whatever you call it, but you are making it in India. And India is looking at us. I mean, world is looking at us. How will we make a product which is cost effective, quality product, and delivery in time? He is in time, on time, bar-bar kehte rahe, as well as service to the customer. That means, how are you interacting? How are you providing the feedbacks? How are you ensuring that things are in place? That's what I have to say, Shikhaji. And Manoji, I know that for 15 years, very good presentation. And you have a lot of work to do at JCB going forward. Once they start the journey in 21, I think 21 will be a great year for all of us. And our mission is to add value to people at the end of the day.
So let's take input from Shikha, ma'am. Any input?
Better human beings and make them better professionals, whatever.
Yeah.
Shikhaji, that's the concept.
It's wonderful speaking to you, DK sir. This was for the first time that I am interacting with you. As Manoj sir said in the beginning of the session, it is really inspiring and gushing of energy listening to you. Just picking up from your last point, you said, you know, you should have internal customization in terms of contracts. I believe that also, sir. And of the belief that anything that gets measured improves. Anything that gets measured improves.
Managed and gets improved continuously.
Yeah, correct. Yeah. Completely agree. So two picks from there. Coming back to what Manoj sir was briefing during the session, two, three points that I've written for myself and my team, the operations head who is going to be looking at the concept, the presentation, the case studies that probably Manoj sir was expecting. So one, what we want is applications used at JCB is something that I should be speaking to them and providing to Manoj sir, so that it gives a crystal clear idea in terms of delivery also, and it becomes more impactful. A couple of things that I wanted to ask Manoj sir is, one, do you want some case studies also from JCB or no, Shikha, as of now applications used will work. Then I will go deeper and work with my team here in case you want some case studies as well.
No. We don't want the case study. During the training sessions, already suppose if you are practicing it, this APKP process. So for the participants exercise, the group exercise, we will require maybe one or two APKP files. So the people will understand the applications of the five phases of the APKP. We can divide into the groups. So we can, in the one group, we can give a certain activities, in another group, we can give another activities, or we can give two groups the same activities. So we can compare it. We can have a more input from this. So assess not. If you want to give any
sir, then,
Yeah, if you just suppose for understanding of SPC or critical parameter, if you want to give me, okay, these are the critical parameter, maybe I can see the process, whether it's a tool control or it's a process control or what kind of the SPC it can be applied in the particular process. So that will help me while I will cover up those topics at their end. So such kind of information, not very much bigger informations.
And in any case, your QMS
wonderful
one, Shikhaji, aapki QMS process must be already on.
Yeah.
So once we understand the QMS process, we will know where you are on ISO 14000, safety, health, environment. So once we scan that, we will be known. We know that this organization has got that capability of QMS process. Aise to aap chal nahi paoge. So wo journey hamare paas. We have done work with very great organizations where QMS process has been very high. But at the same time, there are issues in terms of reaching to the next level of excellence. Apni opportunity hai, next level of excellence. Apni opportunity nahi hai, isko button ko band kar raha na. Apni opportunity hai, isko excellent kaise banaye. इसको कैसे ब्यूटीफुल बनाए, इसको कैसे इनग्रेन करें लोग हु आर वर्किंग ऑन दी दीज इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, हु आर वर्किंग ऑन द शॉप फ्लोर्स, हु आर वर्किंग ऑन द प्रोडक्ट्स. एंड एस्पेशली व्हेन मनोज साल वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट एनपीडी, एंड आई हैव आल्सो ऑब्जर्व्ड इन लाइफ व्हेन वी आर गोइंग फॉर द न्यू प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट, दैट इज द स्टेज वेयर लॉट ऑफ वर्क नीड्स टू बी डन इंस्टेंटली इन ऑर्डर टू create something which is unknown, unheard, unbelievable. Because new product development is an opportunity for you and organization and the people to excel into operational excellence. We call it operational excellence, manufacturing excellence. But NPD is not actually marketing driven. Okay, market mein to market driven hai. But internally, jab hamare paas new product ke liye aate hai, jab sample banta hai, customer ko bhejte hai, that discussions between the customer and the NPD team, main to hamesha life mein, I have always hired an NPD guy, a real techno commercial, you know, with marketing leadership mindset as well as technical, because this NPD is actually our future cash. Am I right, Manoj sir?
Yes, yes, definitely.
So, you need to put a lot of trust when you do such kind of trainings.
Yeah.
Sir, I hear you, sir. Wonderful.
Yes, sir. I am only from HR. Mera manufacturing excellence has been, I have worked for IT. I have worked for manufacturing organizations around the world. That too, world-class manufacturing. World-class. I tell you, you will get amazed to see what kind of work has been done. In places like Romania, Lithuania, Netherlands, England, America, of course, Thailand, Indonesia, Nigeria. नाइजीरिया है वर्ल्ड क्लास प्लांट. सो अगर आप उनको देखेंगे, कभी कभी मेरे को हिंदुस्तान में, सॉरी टू से, जब भी मैं किसी फैक्ट्री में घुसता हूँ तो सबसे पहले बोर्ड देखता हूँ कि लास्ट एक्सीडेंट कब हुआ था. वहां से मेरे को उस कंपनी का पता चलता है कि भाई क्या हाल है इस कंपनी का. वेन वॉज द लास्ट एक्सीडेंट इन दिस एंड वेन वॉज द लास्ट फायर इन दिस कंपनी. जब मैं देखता हूँ 1500 साल पहले फायर हुआ था, मैं देखता हूँ 10 साल पहले लास्ट एक्सीडेंट हुआ था, मेरे को बड़ा फील होता है. आई एम एंटरिंग अ ग्रेट कंपनी, यू नो वी वेंट टू ऑडिट लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज इन द कंट्री. आई थिंक यू डोंट नो अबाउट इट. आई वांट टू गिव यू, वी आर द ओनली कंपनी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मारुति सुजुकी हू ऑडिट वेंडर्स इन द कंट्री. वी हैव डन ऑडिट ऑफ हाउ मेनी कंपनीज वर्षा टिल नाउ?
मोर देन 75 सर.
75 वेंडर्स. एंड वेंडर कोई छोटा वेंडर नहीं है, 100 करोड़ का भी है, 10,000 करोड़ का भी है, 20,000 करोड़ का भी है. Now when you go to a company which is $2 billion and you are going to audit them, actually I tell my people, please go and learn from them, because they are giving us learning a lot, because they are of that kind of companies. So when we audit organizations, we actually learn from those. Yeah, Varsha must have done. आपने कितने audit किए हैं मारुति सुजुकी के vendors के?
Sir, around 15.
15 ऑडिट इसने भी किए, ये 2020 में तो सब बंद हो गया, क्या करें, सॉरी टू से, 15 ऑडिट इसने किए हैं आई थिंक 2019 में, 2019
सर 19
तो मेरा ये मतलब है कि अपने आप हमारा ये भी कर सकते हैं, वी कैन हैव अ जूम कॉल, और इन केस मेरा प्रोग्राम फाइनल होता है वहां आने का जयपुर का फॉर अ सॉफ्ट स्किल ट्रेनिंग इन मिड ऑफ जनवरी, I would love to meet your manufacturing guys. They will understand. I am known as head of the manufacturing mafia. Being an HR person, I love manufacturing mafia people. I call them manufacturing mafia. There are people who have become the CEOs of the companies and they have been my direct customers as manufacturing heads. And they love me. And I would love to meet up with them, manufacturing and operational heads, quality head, manufacturing head, operational head. और अगर मनोज सान भी साथ में होंगे तो दैट विल बी वेरी ग्रेट,
श्योर श्योर,
अंडरस्टैंड आवर लैंग्वेज व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू,
राइट, श्योर,
हमारा ऑब्जेक्टिव एक ही है, जीरो डिफेक्ट, जीरो डिफेक्ट, कॉस्ट क्वालिटी डिलीवरी, कॉस्ट क्वालिटी डिलीवरी एंड कस्टमर सर्विस
जी,
एक्सेलेंट, ये है मैडम अपना, दैट इज व्हाट वी कंट्रीब्यूट टू द कंपनी.
Yes, great, sir. So I'm sure once you're here, we will definitely arrange your meeting with the HODs and the business head also. So a couple of points that I had noted was this training that we're scheduling is for 2 days, right? Though sir did mention that it is a 3 day, it can be extended to a 3 day session also. Yeah. That we're planning for 2 days, sir. Right? प्रोडक्शन पीपल मेंटेनेंस एवरीवन पार्ट ऑफ द ग्रुप. That was one point that I picked from the presentation, just to make you aware of the group. How does the group looking like, sir? Yeah. Also want to understand while we are doing these sessions, you also be sharing some best practices with us in terms of other organizations, case studies, and will you also be sharing some templates? When I say templates, definitely, these are some best practices that people here, the participants here, can make a use of.
Right. Yeah. Sure.
Wonderful. Sir, one more thing. I was not pretty much clear on, how do we do this? You also mentioned something to do with shop floor, doing a little session or a part of the session on the shop floor. So during this 2 day session, will you want me to have this bit also for an hour or two at the shop floor? Or no.
Like I tell you, only the few points. Presentations. Yeah. Yeah, only the few areas, like suppose in a third phase where we go for a process design and development and we are working on spatial characteristic SPC plan or MSA plan. So normally for this process capability and measurement systems, nomenclature remains same or type of instrument remains same, only the parameters to check with that particular instrument gets changed. So we can see practically also, okay, this is the parameter, this is the tolerance. Maybe you are using the same micrometer for the parameter which is special characteristic for the customer in a particular product. But the same micrometer is used for the parameter which is not a special characteristic, is a normal characteristics. So we can see those kind of example at a shop floor just for getting, you can say, more clarity to the participants. Because measurement system and calibration, like we all say, if we measure, we can improve like that. So if our measurement system where we get a data, if our data accuracy is not there, data integrity issues are there, then everything will go as a waste. So very important, that time we can go to the shop floor in that way. FMEA, of course.
And this.
Yeah. For FMEA, we may go to the shop floor just to witness the process.
Wonderful, wonderful, sir. Got the point. So, yeah. Sir, that was pretty much the notes that I had written, basis the presentation, basis some of the queries that I had. I will definitely be looking forward to the two-day session and you visiting our plant. It's a beautiful plant here, wonderful landscape. You will really love to see the JCV Jaipur plant.
Sure. Sure.
It's also told, and it's amongst one of the greenest and most well-maintained in terms of landscape. So I am sure, yeah, I'm sure once you visit, you will be delighted to see the plant.
Manoj is available for travel and all that. Wow, bata dijiyega. And Varsha ke saath coordinate karke, and Varsha will coordinate everything and travel and all that. So whatever needs to be done, we are ready to do it. Second is aap Kamakshi se baat kar dijiyega, madam se. आपके पास पूरा वो डीएनए ऑफ लीडरशिप रोड मैप टू सक्सेस वन ड्रीम वन टीम उसके यूट्यूब से आपने भेजे इनको क्या वर्षा
आई थिंक सर अभी नहीं भेजे यूट्यूब
से भेज दीजिएगा इनको शिखा मैम शी जस्ट एन आईडिया ऑफ द प्रोग्राम एंड अगर फिर मिड ऑफ जनवरी कोई प्रोग्राम बनता है विद सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग वी कैन क्योंकि अभी हमने फेस टू फेस शुरू कर दिया है वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन फेस टू फेस प्रोग्राम्स इन बॉर्डर एंड आई एम इन इंडिया आराम से हम आ सकते हैं अगर दो दिन का प्रोग्राम होता है उसमें आपके ऑपरेशंस हेड और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग हेड भी उस प्रोग्राम में आएंगे लीडरशिप में और आई कैन हैव अ स्टे फॉर वन मोर डे हैव अ डिस्कशन विद योर फंक्शनल हेड्स वन आवर डिस्कशन यू कैन कीप विद फंक्शनल हेड्स अगर मेरा भी प्रोग्राम हो जाता है मैं वर्षा आ जाएंगे एंड वी विल कंडक्ट दिस टू डेज प्रोग्राम आप इनको यूट्यूब भेज दीजिएगा सारा
यस सर
Sure, sure, Varsha. So I'll wait. It'll really give more clarity in terms of the content that we can cover during the programs.
Right.
And of course, then we can definitely have call with Bakshi, sir. So it'll at least give us a frame of mind in terms of the program design.
Because abhi 31 January tak to Hindustan se bahar jana nahi hai. So opportunity.
Wonderful. Sir, the dates of the programs, I will soon be confirming. As I told, we were completely in a hush-bush to figure this out, do the vendor registration, figure out the training programs and all.
Oh,
so was really running tight ropes on, you know, the execution. We'll quickly freeze the dates between today and tomorrow in consultation with the operations head and the manufacturing technical head.
Yeah, because I want to tell you, Manoj is a star performer. His dates already booked even for today. He changed the schedule because I told him, yeah, you only have to come for this introduction. You will yourself find out and you will get the feedback from your employees after attending the program, you will yourself know. And Maruti, I will tell you one time, I used to do programs for Maruti car plant. And suddenly Japanese said, DK Bakshi should do program for this engine plant, SPIL. Usko bolte the un dino. Baad mein wo bhi Maruti ki man. But as Suzuki Power India Limited. So, mere jo rating aati thi car plant mein, in a scale of 1 to 5, I used to get 4.8, 4.9. Ab mein, jab mein SPIL mein gaya, it's on record, and we have shown that, SPIL mein gaya, to SPIL mein, मेरी जो ये आ गई रेटिंग आ गई 4.6 आ गई शिखा जी आप सुन रहे हैं शिखा जी नहीं यू आर म्यूटेड
सर आई वाज जस्ट डिस्कनेक्टिंग अ कॉल देयर वाज सम बैक टू बैक कॉल्स बाय द प्लांट हेड जस्ट डिस्कनेक्टेड एंड ड्रॉप्ड हिम अ मैसेज
Okay, can I talk?
Sir, am I audible, sir?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes, you can, sir.
I just want to give an example. When I was doing programs, I used to come from Bangkok, do program for Maruti car plant. So my rating was in a scale of 1 to 5, 4.8, 4.9. Suddenly, Japanese said that DK Bakshi should do program at SPIL, Suzuki Power India Limited, which was another company of, engine company of, Maruti Suzuki. Now this is the same company. I'm talking about, I say, 5-6 years ago. जब मैं वहां प्रोग्राम किया मेरी रेटिंग आ गई 4.5 4.6. तो मेरी एक लड़की काम कर रही थी आजकल वो यूएसए में है एंड शी गॉट मैरिड इन यूएसए. तो मेरे को जब मैं लैंड कर गया होटल में मिला क्या तो सब बड़ी प्रॉब्लम हो गई. आई सेड व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम. ही सेड जापानीज आर क्वेश्चनिंग यूर ट्रेनिंग. आई सेड व्हाट क्वेश्चन. ही सेड व्हाई डी के बख्शी हैज गॉट ओनली 4.6 एंड वायरलेस ही यूज्ड टू गेट 4.8 4.9. आई सेड इवैल्यूएट. आई सेड कहां हुआ ये. कहते सर एसबीआईएल में हुआ. मैंने कहा एसबीआईएल में क्यों हुआ. तो फाइनली शी सेड टुडे दे आर मीटिंग यू जापानीज और जापानीज का ट्रांसलेटर साथ होता है. तो फिर मैंने उनको एक्सप्लेन किया. मैंने कहा यहाँ पे जो मैं प्रोग्राम कर रहा हूँ पिछले साल भर से रेगुलर कर रहा हूँ एसपीआईएल में पहली बार में गया हूँ और मेरे इस प्रोग्राम का रेटिंग जो है 4.5 4.6 आया. कैन यू टेल मी रेटिंग ऑफ अदर ट्रेनर्स. तो जब उन्होंने दिखाया दैट वॉज 3.8 से नीचे. मैंने कहा जापानीज को मैंने कहा मैं आपको समझाना चाहता हूँ आई एम स्टिल हाई बट when you get used, why I'm giving you this, this thing, when you get used to training these people in a company, your rating also starts going up. When I'm looking at Manoji, and I'm having respect for him, when Manoji will start doing programs, and you will see that people will start loving Mr. Manoj. He will become a mentor for them. So, then SPI when he used to change over, वहाँ भी मैं 4.8, 4.9 पे पहुँचा, because when you do regular interactions as facilitators, as trainers with the team, at the end of the day, हमारा क्या है? हमारा काम ये है कि people should get value to their life. So they become mentees and they become part of your life. Whether we are there or not, people are still in contact at a personal level. So with the passage of time, when you do 2, 3, 4 programs, you will see Manoj-san will become one of an important element for your technical people. And ladies and gentlemen, whosoever is going to be watching this, this is a fact of life. Allow us to get adjusted in your organization, JCB, and you will see that our people will deliver value to your people. Because at the end of the day, each and every participant in our classrooms is our valued customer. Whether he is a supervisor, whether he is an associate, whether he is a general manager, is our valued customer. And customer is a king, customer is a god. That is the principle we have, Shikha ma'am. Thank you very much.
My message. Wonderful, sir. I completely, completely echo with what you're saying. Completely echo.
Thank you, ma'am.
So great, sir. Varsha, now what I'm awaiting, what you are awaiting from me is the date. The details of the participants and a couple of initial discussions that we did, applications, the files that are required during the session. So should be sorted. This is a question to Manoj sir. Manoj sir, in case my manufacturing head, the MEP head who's largely overseeing all the trainings, wants to have a clarity on a couple of things, is that okay to touch base with you over some 5-10 minutes call?
Yeah, sure.
Varsha, I'll seek your help there.
Okay, not an issue.
Wonderful.
He is the customer. He is the customer. Anita. Customer के लिए आपको मिठाई खड़े हो जाते हैं. Customer कैनेडा में बैठे हैं, यूएसए में बैठे हैं. Time zones में पता ही नहीं चलता. रात को 12 बजे भी बात करते हैं. So we are ready. We are 24/7. Don't worry.
Wonderful, sir.
Now you will YouTube from Varsha in next half an hour. She will the recording will get into YouTube with introductory program at JCB. YouTube, the name of YouTube will be sent to you, and then you can share with your people.
I will share in some time once recording is downloaded and then uploaded on YouTube.
I will send it to you.
That should be good, Varsha. That's okay. Okay, should be good.
Okay.
Great. Thank you, sir. Varsha, thank you so much.
Thank you, Shikha. Thank you, Varsha. Thank you, sir. And wish you all happy new year.
Same to you.
A very happy new year to all of us, sir. Yes.
Very good. Manoji, do it.
Much needed and desired happy new year, sir.
This year will be a brilliant year for human race. Don't worry. Power of positive.
Should be, sir. Should be.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Take care, sir.